Hey there, friends. What is up? I'm Chris Ewing, educator, fabricator, and finally mustachioed gentleman. In my last video, I showed you guys how to make some end tables using some really inexpensive equipment. And one of the questions I got on that video is, hey, can you show me how to TIG weld with a machine that inexpensive? It's not designed for that, but I think we can make it work. Let's give it a shot. So before we talk about the super inexpensive setup, let's go over the parts and pieces of a traditional TIG setup. So right here we've got our Lincoln Aspect 375 Great TIG machine, and it's hooked up to this Cool Arc 47 water cooler. So there's two different types of torches out there. There's water cooled and there's air cooled. This particular unit utilizes this water cooling machine, works just like the radiator in your car. We've got water out to the torch or coolant out to the torch. We've got our coolant line back in, as well as our power. And then we've also got our shielding gas, in this case, 100% argon, that are all going out to our TIG torch. That allows us to operate at higher amperages and for a longer period of time than a traditional air-cooled torch. The other big difference between a traditional machine like this and our setup that we're gonna have is the foot pedal or whatever variable control you're using. What this allows us to do is set our top end amperage on the machine. So this right now, I don't know if you can see it on the screen, set to 120 amps. That means pedal to the floor is 120 amps. It arc initiates somewhere between 5 and 20, depending on the machine, and then it will go up to whatever top end we have the set to, pedal to the floor. Being this is a 375, allows us to go up to 250 amps max. So I can put it 250 amps and then I can actuate this foot pedal. It initiates my arc, it sends my shielding gas, and I have that variability on the foot pedal. Now there are other torch designs out there that will have a finger adjustment right on the torch itself so that we can vary the amperage there. Or sometimes it's a simple button on and off. When you hit that button on, you get your gas, electricity, you hit it off again, your gas and electricity cut out on you. All right, so this little machine should look familiar from my last video. This is my little Deco inverter welding machine that I got off of Amazon. It was 120 when I bought it. Now it's all the way up to 130, if you're looking it up right now. It comes with the weld machine, a stick welding stinger lead, and we have our work clamp, decent gauge cables. I think it came with a wire brush slash chipping hammer thing too that was totally above average. This is the machine we're going to be using. So how do we turn this bad boy into a TIG welder? Well, again, the wonderful world of Amazon sells us these YESWELDER TIG torches. Now, full disclosure, if you don't have a welding machine yet, YESWELDER sells a kit that comes with the welding machine and these leads and the TIG torch, so you don't have to buy this separately. I did not have this already. Cost me 50 bucks. So far, I think it's gonna turn out to be worth it. The lead is 12 feet long and the gas line is 16 feet long. So, I mean, it gives you a decent amount of space. This particular machine uses the 1025 DINS connectors. And so that's the little guys with the little block on it. You just plug it in, thread it clockwise, and it's locked in there. The traditional MIG setup, TIG setup like we were just looking at, would use a 3550 DINS connector. So it's a slightly larger diameter on the part that threads in there. These ones you'll usually find on machines that go up to 200 amps. I believe our TIG torch is rated for 150 amps. And you'll see instead of three lines going into it, our gas, water in, and water out, here all we have is our electrical line with what is a scarily thin lead cable, and we have our shielding gas line. Let's figure out where these guys go. On a traditional stick welding setup, most of the time we are going to have our stick welding lead on the positive side, DC electrode positive, and then our work clamp on the negative side. When we're TIG welding, that's actually going to be reversed. So we are going to get rid of our stinger entirely, we are going to transfer our work clamp to the positive side, and then we're going to put our new TIG torch into the negative side. We then have to go ahead and install our gas line into our gas supply. For TIG welding, we're going to use 100% argon, and then this has to get threaded into our flow meter. So let's do that now. 100% argon, flow meter already attached, tank is off. Just going to go ahead and thread this guy in here. Give a little snuggy-do. And we can open our tank. All right, so something else I wanted to point out real quick is I just got this threaded into the flow meter. I've got my tank turned on. This is a $50 TIG torch. It is by not any means not the nicest torch I've ever used. I've got the little valve closed all the way, but yeah, it's leaking. If you read the Amazon reviews, this is a pretty common problem with these. I've got it tightened all the way. So what this is our gas valve. There is no foot pedal in this setup to actuate the gas and the electricity to turn on. So what do? Before we weld, we open this up. Yeah, it's still leaking when it's closed. So I might open this up a little more and see if I can't figure out why. Maybe there's just a gasket or an O-ring or something in there that's leaking. It shouldn't affect the function, but it is a little annoying and a little wasteful of our shielding gas. So keep that in mind, you get what you pay for. All right, so what else comes in this nifty box with this TIG torch? We get our very own consumables kit. Now we have three different gas cups, 4, 5, and 6. That all refers to the opening at the end of the cup there. How wide is that in diameter? We have a small and a large back cap that traps the shielding gas and makes sure it's only going out the direction it's supposed to. And we have our collet body with our gas diffuser. So this will go in first. And all these holes is where the gas is supposed to come out of there. And then we have three different dimension collets, 1/16, 3/32, and a 1/8. All pretty much standard for basically any TIG torch that you'll get. Let's go ahead and get our TIG torch set up. Let's start with our collet body. Thread that guy in there. And we'll go for the number 6 gas cup. Put that on there next. I will be using the 3/32 collet to go with the 3/32 tungsten that doesn't ship with the torch. So unfortunately, you're stuck providing your own tungsten. In my case, I'm using a 2% seriated. That's the gray stuff. A lot of people have great results with the E3 purple rare earth tungsten. This should work with just about anything you've got on hand. Industry is trying to get away from the red 2% thoriated because it is in fact radioactive. All right, so let's get our tungsten threaded in there and our back cap. Set our stick out distance a little more appropriately. And there we have an assembled torch. All right, so before I turn the machine on, let's talk technique for getting this arc initiated. Now we said with a traditional setup, we're gonna have a foot pedal that as soon as we hit that pedal, it's gonna initiate the arc. We can have that high frequency start, make sure the arc jumps from the tungsten to the part. That way we never have to make contact with our part with our tungsten. This setup doesn't have that. So how do we get it started? Just like we would in stick welding. We gotta get that tungsten close enough and maybe scratch or tap. We either call that scratch start or lift start. So we're basically gonna have to do a lift start, get that arc initiated with the gas flowing. We can perform our weld, and then we have to break the arc and come back to make sure that we're still gas shielding the end of our weld. So that's the technique for an inexpensive setup like this. Let me go ahead and get the machine turned on and show you how it welds. So here I've got some 11 gauge mild steel, just regular carbon steel. Up here, you can see that I've got the machine set to, on the screen here, it says 22, but I don't trust that. Up here, it says 65. I think that's a little bit more accurate. We'll see how it goes. Cheap machine, cheap readout. Don't expect terrible accuracy. And then here we've got our 16th inch ER70S-6 filler wire. All right, so I'm purging the area before I initiate that arc. And then like I said, I'm gonna have to get real close and scratch start. Now again, if I'm using a traditional setup, I'll have either a finger wheel or a foot pedal where I can control the amperage in real time. If I see it's getting too hot, I can back off, or too cold, I can add. In this situation, my travel speed and my arc manipulation are pretty much my only controls, how much filler I add to. Kind of whip out of there, allow the gas to shield the end of the weld there. And I think it was running just a little on the hot side. Got a little bit of underfill along the top edge there. Let's get you closer so y'all can see that weld as well. Not too bad. All right, let's give that a shot one more again with the weld lens on here. And maybe you can get a little more detailed view. All right, and here we have our first happy little weld. And here we can see that second happy little weld. So this 11 gauge material welded just fine with this $120 welder and $50 TIG torch. All right, so there you have it, Mr. Zach McCoy. You asked if we could TIG weld with this machine. It can be done. In fact, I'm actually kind of impressed at how easily it went, how everything hooked up. I might invest in a nicer TIG torch than the $50 YESWELDER version that's leaking gas all over the place. If you can get past that, $130 for welder, $50 for TIG torch, and you're up and running. Mild steel, this will work on stainless also, but keep in mind, this is not an AC machine, so you're not gonna be able to TIG weld aluminum with it. Having said that, I think this is a great option for people that are just looking to dip their feet into the TIG welding world. Let me know what you think in the comments, and until next time, hope this helps.